Well, howdy, 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 folks. We're going to talk about naming your business and specifically your hot dog business because that's my cup of tea. And I want, or it's my hot dog. I want to talk to you about naming your business, the two things that you need to make sure to do so you don't run into trouble later, but also ease your worries about, oh, I got to get this exactly right. Okay. So what I'm going to do first is let me pull this up real quick. Let's see. I wish I could share my screen. I'm using a different software and I can't share my screen. But let me read this real quick. So basically there's somebody that emailed me. I had three of these today. One was a phone call. A lady just is having trouble coming up with a name. And then two of them were similar. They found names they want to use, but there's similar names already in use, or and they don't know what the legality. Do they have to trademark their name? Do I have to put a patent on my name? And I'm going to simplify that for you real quick and make this easy for you. So this person wanted a certain name, okay? And it says there's already a closely named to another business here in Texas. Would it cause confusion for my customers if I was to use another name that I already have set up? And then he gives me that name and he says, and then later I can switch to this name once I have permission from that other business with the similar name. Well, here's the deal. When naming your business, let me give you an example. When I first opened, I was Hillbilly Hot Dogs, just Hillbilly Hot Dogs. And Hillbilly Hot Dogs, as I grew, other people heard about me and they named their business Hillbilly Hot Dogs because I didn't have a trademark and I wasn't incorporated yet. So there was multiple Hillbilly Hot Dogs. And now after years in business, there's Hillbilly Hot Dogs all over the place, Kentucky, West Virginia, Virginia, all these little southern mountain areas. There's a lot of Hillbilly Hot Dogs. Now, could one of those incorporate their name? Yes. Does that stop anybody in another state from using the same name? Nope. Okay. The only thing that prevents somebody from copying a name and a logo is a trademark. Okay. It is not something that is important to me to get that done right now. You know, when you're starting out, wait. And even then, is it really necessary to trademark it? You can trademark, but is it necessary? So I like to do things the easier way, especially not spend money on something that isn't really that important. So now if you're planning on going to franchise out, I'd wait till you start doing that. Then you go ahead and trademark a name. The first thing, though, before you start all this, there's some things you can do is you can look for you always want to have the word catering in it. This is the number one thing I want to tell you. And we've been, you know, preaching this for 3-4 years now. Always put the word catering in it. So, you know, today I talked to a vendor and he gave me his name. He's been in business a while and it's still just, we were doing a private consult, but his name is still something, something hot dogs. Well, it's actually just dogs, right? So it's something, something dogs. Well, that something, something dogs says hot dogs, but it doesn't tell what all he does. And he does a lot. He does catering. But he's had to like educate people. It doesn't say it in his message, in his title, in his name. So you want to use a name that is indicative of what you're doing. If you're going, well, I ain't going to cater. Well, then you probably need knocked in the head because you're going to find out that you can make a whole lot of money catering. And if you don't know anything about it, I ain't talking about catering like these big restaurants do. I'm talking about simple catering. I'm even talking drop-off catering. I'm talking the kind of catering where you don't even touch the cart. If you want to learn about that, I've got the information for free for you. And so I'm not going to go into it here, but go to learnhotdogs.com and then just type in the word drop-off or catering and you'll be overwhelmed with the amount of things that pro vendors are doing to make extra money or to just do. Okay. So put the word catering in your name. If it's Hillbilly's Hot Dogs and Catering, a lot of vendors now are doing their name Hillbilly's Catering and Hot Dogs because you don't want to pigeonhole. I've got a good friend, Jason Brown, with Love Food Truck. He goes, never pigeonhole yourself. He pigeonholed himself in the beginning. He was Love Hot Dog Company. Well, then he changed it to Love Food Truck. A lot more meaning in that than pigeonholing himself into hot dogs. So that's one important thing. The second important thing is to get paid like RJ, Scott Schaefer, Carl Loper. Thanks for being here. The second thing, and this is where it comes to trying to figure out, can I legally use this name? Okay. Because when you go to the town hall or the county office to get your name, to register your DBA, doing business as, let's say, you're not going to do a corporation at first. Let's say you're going to do it the smart way. Just start with a DBA, save the money, right? So you go in to get your business license. What's the name of your company going to be? What are you DBAing as? Hillbilly Hot Dogs. They're not going to go, oh, no, you can't, because the next county over, Knox County, they have somebody's using that. They don't check. They don't even care. Okay. Now, if you go to incorporate, like you're going to create an LLC or an incorporation, then, hey, Joe, then what you'll want to do is contact the state. You can call a number or you can go online. Most of them now are online, and I can type in check a corporation name availability, corporate name availability in my state, and check those names against your ideas. And that way you can see if there's names being used already, if that exact name's being used. Usually, hey, Jeff, Matt, usually, I was just talking about your state. Usually you will have a name that's similar. You know, if you're doing, a lot of people use a lot of the same types of names in businesses. I'm sure you've noticed. There's one that around here, and it's in North Carolina, South Carolina, and Tennessee. I've seen this lawn care company, and it's not the same company, but they all have the same name, and it's called Lawn Enforcement. It's a play on words. They have all of them used a sheriff's badge or something, and it looks like their trucks look like police trucks or something, some shape, form, or fashion of law enforcement. It's a brilliant play on words, but that just shows you other people are doing the same thing. It is quite possible for two people to have the same idea at roughly the same time on different parts of the world. That just happens. There's too many people. There's almost 8 billion people on the planet now. So, original ideas, they are few and far between. Original to you, but not maybe to someone else. So the bottom line is you go on there and check the names. Then you can call the state. It's free. Call them and say, hey, I was thinking about this name. I did look up online and it has this name. Is that going to be a clash? Some states do not care. If you add an S, they'll go, oh, you added an S. You're good to go. It's a different name. Some states are more anal about it and they don't want you to be close. Now, let me tell you things not to do. Don't go and try to name your company Pepsi Hot Dog Company and Catering, because the word Pepsi's trademarked pretty hard and they got lots of lawyers. All right. And so you don't want to use something like that, but it's easy to, create a name that is legal and you'll be protected. If you're incorporating, it still doesn't really protect your name, because somebody, like, you could be in the Tri-Cities, Tennessee. Okay. That's right there on the edge of Virginia and pretty close to West Virginia and touching North Carolina and touching Kentucky right there. So you could quite possibly be John's Big Bad Catering and Hot Dogs, and there'll be one of those in other states, but it doesn't matter. That doesn't matter. You're not going to protect your name in other states unless you go and register corporations with that name or get trademarked. And then even if you had a trademark for lawn enforcers, right? Like I was just telling you, even if you had it trademarked, the burden of proof is on you, and you'd have to go after them in federal court, federal trademark court. Lots of money. So it's a challenge. What I do is I tell people not to worry about it. Create a name that you want. Make sure that it's not the same name somebody's already incorporated in your state with. Then use that name. And if other people copy it, so be it. Okay? So be it. It's not the end of the world. Do the best you can and you'll be fine. I've got a manufacturer who copies my cart names. Now, we have them trademarked. Okay? So ours are trademarked. He still copied them. And when we threatened him, you know, our lawyers threatened him with a federal lawsuit, he just changed them up a little bit. Just a little bit. And this is a guy that's been sued by Harley Davidson. He's been sued, but he doesn't care. He likes being sued, apparently. But the bottom line is you, with the vending business, you just don't worry. You just have to go, okay, I'm gonna do my name. I'm going to pick a good name that is descriptive of who I am. Okay. What I'm serving, and then go from there. That's the best advice I can give you on choosing a name. And here's the thing where it doesn't matter. You know, you can always change your name. You can change your name. So you don't always have to keep that name. Jason Brown, he wishes he would have started with Love Food Truck Company instead of Love Hot Dog, you know, Love Hot Dog Company. But he changed it. It wasn't the end of the world. It happens. I named my hot dog cart company Ben's Carts, you know, because my ego, right? Which is an ego move, even if you don't even realize it, it's an ego move, right? It was an ego move. And then later I'm going, well, that was stupid. I'm not Ford, you know, where people go, oh, I know Ford or Dodge or Chevy, you know, I'm Ben. So why did I name it Ben's Carts? So later we changed to Hot Dog Cart Store. What does that tell you? It tells you what the freaking we do. Ben's Carts could be golf carts, could be, I mean, all, you know, little red wagon cart. It could be a number of different things. Just keep that in mind when you go. Jeff Matt Green Envy, Bob Abraham is in the house. Hey, Ben, looking to do this when I retire from the military. Great topic. Scott, we have a ton of people from the military doing this. We've got people that are retired military, veterans of vets, you know, military vets that didn't like retire, but they served their 5 years or 3 years or whatever. You'll love it. You'll love our crowd. They're good people. Well, anyway, I hope y'all are having a good weekend. I guess we're all getting cold weather and crappy weather. I know that if y'all weren't watching today, Lemonade Vending, which is Warren Russell, who's a friend of ours and just a good guy. He makes the lemonade squisher smasher thingamabob. And he is doing a big event this weekend. Who else was out today, even though I guess they're not having this bad of weather? Boss Dogs, Billy. He was training today. He was training people. Some people came and through our little program where we'll let you train for free. You don't even have to buy nothing and go train with a pro vendor. He had people there training today and sent me video. There's a lot of cool stuff happening. If you want to do the training, it's learnhotdogs.com/best day ever. Thanks, Ben. I'm 24 years in right now. Wow. Scott, thank you for your service. That's freaking awesome. 24 years in the military. That's a long time. I had a buddy, he retired at 38 with 20 years in. And I was envious because I was going, man, you're done. You're retired. And at 38. And so it's cool. My daughter did five. I still brag about that. You know, that's nowhere near 24, but I'm proud. Proud dad. Anyway, I love y'all. If you have any questions, message me, put them on here, wherever they go and we'll find them. And then I'll try to get them answered. Thanks for all your questions and everything. Sandwich Brats on the go. Howdy, howdy, Jeff Mack starting downtown Dallas Monday morning past all my BS hoops. Cannot wait to get started. Y'all need to be following Jeff Mack. Wait till you see his cart and stuff. I posted it up on the Facebook page. He has got a gorgeous wrapped Cater Pro beautiful cart. He wrapped it vinyl. It is just cool. Wait till y'all see it. Jeff, you ought to post up here in the comments the link to your Facebook page. Y'all see, if you start following these vendors, you get ideas too. You know, there's some cool names for companies. Like, there was, this kind of goes along, Dogma Dogs. I like that one. Dogma Dogs and Karma Dogs. And there's so many things you can do, with it. We have one that's NASA Dogs, because guess what? We have a Cater Pro. NASA bought a Cater Pro and has it out there at Cape Canaveral, which actually sent a rocket off today, which was cool. Peace Dogs. That's it. Peace Dogs Catering. Jeff just posted that up if you want to follow him. Anyway, y'all have a good one. I'm going to go salt my driveway.